Hello students, in this class we will see about various ports. What are these ports? In computer hardware, a port serves as an interface between computer and computers, other computers or peripheral devices. Here peripheral devices means the devices which are connected to the computer. All the devices that you can connect to a computer, all those devices are known as peripheral devices. You can connect monitor, you can connect a keyboard, mouse, or anything. In computer term, a port generally refers to part of computing device available for connection to peripherals such as input or output devices. To a computer, we connect various devices. You can see a diagram of various ports, this back side or in the side, the various ports are there. So in this class, we'll learn how many common ports are there through which we can connect our various devices. Computer ports have many uses to connect a monitor, connect a webcam, speaker, or other devices. On the physical layer, the computer port is a specialized outlet on a piece of equipment to which a plug or cable connects. Now you might be getting the point what I'm trying to tell. So look, types of port. These are the various types of port: digital visual interface, display port, eSATA port, PS2, serial, SCSI, all these are there. Okay. So we have serial port. Look the diagram. This kind of port you might see mostly in the desktops. You will see this. Or in laptops also, this kind of ports are there. This is known as serial port. What is the task? Sends and receive one bit at a time via single wire pair. Means, look students, everything in a computer is done with the help of 0 and 1. The signals are sent. The signal for 0 and signal for 1 is sent. So serial port send or receive in serial. Serial means what? It's series, one by one. So sends and receive one bit at a time. Although it's very fast, bits are also transferred at very fast rate, but one by one. One after that, another bit, that, like that. On the other hand, we have parallel port. Looks similar to that, but has more number of pins. And it can send multiple bits at a time over several sets of wire. Means a parallel port, which looks like this, has a lot of wires and each wire carries a bit parallelly. Parallelly means all together. Okay. So this is how it works a little faster. Okay. After ports are connected, they typically require handshaking. Handshaking is something like where transfer type, transfer rate, and other necessary information said before data is sent. Look, handshaking is one of the terminology which is used when we are talking about data communication. Data communication means if you are sending a data from one device to another device, then you should be sure that yes, the data is all sent to that device. So handshaking is kind of look, read this out. In telecommunication, a handshake is an automated process of negotiation between two participants. Two participants are here, two devices. Through the exchange of information that establish the protocol of a communication link at the start of the communication before. I mean, it simply means that before sending or transmitting data between the devices, first we should check if there is proper link or not. So handshaking is to check two devices has good link and then the transmission starts. So in this way, we have a few terminologies which we need to discuss in detail, or you must know these common terminologies which are used in data communication between devices, which is plug and play. Plug and play means what? In computing, a plug and play, which is also known as PNP device or computer bus, I'll tell you what is bus, is one with a specification that facilitates The discovery of hardware component in system without the need for physical device configuration or user intervention and this and that. Listen, students, it's a not so simple statement written about plug and play, but let me tell you in a simple language. Plug and play, as the name suggests, when you connect any device with your computer, what happens? Few devices start working instantly. So such thing is known as plug and simply play. Example of plug and play devices. Example of plug and play devices are like when you connect mouse or when you connect a keyboard to a system, desktop or laptop or any other device, you can connect keyboard and mouse to the mobile phone also, tablets also. So and as and when you just put it in the USB, universal serial bus, that is one of the port, then it starts playing. It starts working. That's called plug and play. Like pen drive also, when you insert it, then it starts. So this is called plug and play. But few other devices are there which need a lot of configuration and other thing to work. For example, a printer. A printer does not work like that. That you have directly connected a printer to the system and it starts working. You need to put the driver, you need to a little configuration and then it starts. So plug and play means just plug and play. Printer, you cannot tell printer as the plug and play device. One thing is here, auto detect or auto detection port are usually plug and play. Now let me tell you, what is auto detect? Dear students, this has been told to you in the previous class when I was discussing software, different types of software. In that discussion, I told you about one special type of software, a type of system software, device driver. I've told you. If you do not remember, then I'll tell you back. Device driver is a special set of software. And that software is really very important to run any device, to drive any device. The thing is, every piece of hardware, either small or big, no matter, every single piece of hardware needs a software to work. Whether it is a keyboard, whether it is a mouse or pen drive or any other hardware there, that needs what? That needs a software to work. And that software which make the device to work, to which make the device run, that special set of software is known as device driver. So this is what device driver is. So for most of the common devices, like keyboard and mouse is most common, pen drives are most common devices. So the driver for such hardware is inbuilt in the operating system. Operating system, it already contains the required software to at least run the mouse and the keyboard, the common devices. So when we connect any device, the operating system detects it. It recognizes it, what kind of device is attached to the computer. And if it has, it means the operating system has the appropriate driver for that device, then it installs the driver for that particular hardware, and then that hardware starts working. You may find this when you buy a new pen drive, then you will find it very you'll see this happening. Just buy a new pen drive or even mouse or keyboard and insert for the first time in your system, and you will see that it will display a notification that yes, one hardware is found and the software is being installed, and now your device is ready to use. So this is what, this is called detection and auto detection and installation of the driver for that particular device. Now, which are such devices whose driver is not there in the operating system? Look, printers are one such devices which has lot and lot of varieties. Various companies are there, and in each company they have lot and lot of different types of printer, which with different make and model, different prices are there, different features and facilities are there. So it is not always possible to have all the drivers or all the softwares with all the printers available in the world. So when you buy such devices, I'm not talking only about a printer, I'm talking about such devices which are not common, most common, or which have varieties. So a CD or a DVD comes with them having the device driver of that particular device in them. Or you may get it downloaded from the appropriate website of that device. Like if you have purchased an HP printer or Canon printer or Epson printer of any particular model, like if you have purchased Epson L320 or any model, then either you will get a CD or DVD along with that, or you may download it and you can install it. So here, student, what we try to understand, actually we are trying to understand ports. Ports are the outlets or input points through which we connect different devices. And in this run, we encountered what? Plug and play devices, auto detection. So to make you understand what is plug and play, what is auto detection and all, I'm just telling you these things. So what is a device driver? Device driver is very important. For few common devices, device driver is already there in the operating system. So whenever you put the device, it gets installed and it starts working. Whereas few devices, they may be common, but there is a lot of varieties. So it's not possible always to have all kind of softwares. Because how many of you have printer? If 100 users are buying or purchasing a laptop, but out of 100, only 10 or 20 are purchasing printers. So that's not needed. If you'll add all the device drivers of such devices, then the size of operating system will be increased. So now, what I'm telling you, now let us continue. So students, let us try to see some more kind of ports. Actually, this article contains a lot of detailed discussion. Let us see then. As of 2006, manufacturers have nearly standardized colors associated with ports on personal computers. Although there are no guarantees, the following is the short list. Orange, purple, or gray. This is for keyboard, PS2. PS2, I'll show you the diagram. There must be there, the PS2 diagram. PS2 diagram, 1 minute, let me show you. This is one of the PS2 port. Portable system. Look, it's nice. This kind of port you might see in the back side of a desktop and in older laptops. But nowadays, this is not there in even in the new desktops also, you will not find this. It has been replaced by the USB. So this is PS2 port, and try to understand. Orange, if you'll see orange color, purple color, or gray color, then this port will be for the keyboard, PS2 keyboard. PS2 keyboard has this, it does not have the USB. It has the PS2 pins, which get inserted into PS2 port. Whereas the green color indicates the mouse. Same port is there, similar. You can find it in any old desktop, you will easily find it. Blue or magenta. Parallel printer. Okay, so these are classification of different ports that if you find that the different colors are there of this kind, so you might easily understand that which device, for which device that particular port is meant for. This is the name of color And amber color is for serial DB25 and DB9. This pastel pink is for microphone. Pastel green is for speakers and all. So types of port, yes. Now DVI, digital visual interface. It look like this. And obviously it is used for connecting video camera and other digital visual devices with this port. It's normal there in the cameras and other such devices. Dear students, that's very nice piece of information you'll find here. You'll not find these things in all everywhere, especially in your book, you will not get these things. And most of you see these ports, but you don't know what are they. These are the different display ports. Look, these things you'll find in mostly you'll find in laptops, this kind of port. It looks like a USB. Most of you get confused and try to insert a pen drive in it, but no, this is not a USB. This is display port. This is mini display port. In few laptops, this mini display port is there. Why it is used? It is used to connect any output device. Like if you have a large TV with you or a projector with you, and you want to connect your laptop having these display ports to that larger devices or output devices, then you can connect it. This is display port cable. This is mini display port. And this is not mini, normal display port. Further, you may find eSATA. Look, this also you can find in desktops and mostly in the laptops you'll find. New laptops, you'll find this thing. Is eSATA. You can find it easy to enlarged version. I'm zooming it for you. This is eSATA. Okay. This is used for attach hard disk for faster access. Now here comes the PS2. Look, this is called the PS2. PS2. This is serial bus. This may be used for connecting normal VGA, the visual graphics adapter or visual graphics array. The monitors are usually connected with that. Look at this. The serial port. This is serial port. Okay. This is not used for connecting monitor. This is used for VGA regulator. This is used for, this was used earlier days. In earlier days, I have also used very long back to connect mouse. Earlier when mouse were coming, at that time optical mouse were also not there. Okay, ball, rubber ball mouse were there. They were connected using this serial port. Nowadays they are not too much used. VGA, of course, the monitor is connected with this, normal monitors. Look, SCSI. This is another set of port. Few kind of printers and other devices get connected using these ports. One of the most common port is USB port. So which should especially look at the USB port, because this is one of the most common device port through which we connect most of the device nowadays. Look, USB full form is universal serial bus. So look at the different versions, USB 1, USB 2, USB 3. So as the version of USB is increasing, the speed and the transfer rate is also increasing across the devices. So look at the diagrams. These all are USB. So dear students, in this class, look, more detail. This also is an example of the USB. You can just see these articles for more and more information, but light information is enough at your level. So a lot of things there. Different USB devices you can see. mini USB, these disconnection points you may find in the mobile phones. So type C USB is also there. In newer mobile phones, you may find type C connection like this. So you may find a lot of varieties there in USB. And large range of devices are connected using these ports. So dear students, in our this class, we tried to understand various different ports. And ports are the points through which we attach peripheral devices. And this is how it works. So thank you, student, and say something more in the next class.